Authorities have opened the vaults found inside the raided Lucky South 99 Pogo Hub in Pampanga. Zian Ambrosia is there. She's going to give us the latest now. Zian, go ahead.
Carmina, members of the PIDG, together with the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commissioner, PAO, and the Anti-Money Laundering Counselor, AMLAC, went back to Lucky South 99 Pogo Hub here in Porac, Pampanga, with their break-open vault operation for the 81 vaults found in the buildings of this Pogo Hub. In the first vault, Carmina, they used a crowbar and a hammer to open it. And surprisingly, they saw 23 cell phones, an iPad, a tea bag, and a Chinese passport. In another vault, they recovered a bundle of 500 peso bills amounting to more or less 50,000 pesos. Authorities have yet to examine all the pieces of evidence, including the cell phones, where they can possibly extract more information, which can be used in their investigation. The CIDG assures that all vaults are intact and have never been transferred to other locations. Last June, Lucky South 99 was raided by the PAO, where they were able to arrest more than 100 foreigners for immigration violations. Several computers were recovered in almost every building, where there were reports of alleged torture, illegal detention, and scamming inside this hub. And that's the latest here in Porac, Pampanga. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosia, there joining us on the line. A new survey shows satisfaction of Filipinos with President Marcos has improved. According to the latest Social Weather Station survey, 55% are satisfied with the president's performance, 28% are dissatisfied, while 15% are undecided. The poll was conducted from June 23 to July 1. The chief executive's net satisfaction rating is at plus 27, up from plus 20 in March 2024. The president's net satisfaction rating was highest in Luzon. It also saw a 24 percentage point increase among Mindanao respondents. The survey also showed, compared to October 2022, those who saw the country will very much benefit from Marcos's foreign trips was halved to just 8%, while those who saw almost no benefit stands at 17%. And let's now get an outlook on the weekend weather from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. It's going to be a warm and humid weekend with possible afternoon or evening thunderstorms in some parts of the archipelago. A weak southwest monsoon or habagat is blowing over the western sections of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, but it will not bring significant or continuous rains. This Friday, intense thunderstorms are expected later this afternoon over central Luzon, Palawan, western and central Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, northern Mindanao, and Caraga. Saturday and Sunday will see less rains and much warmer and drier conditions. Rain showers may still be experienced in some areas, especially in Ilocos Region, Cordillera, Palawan, and Panay Island. Metro Manila will also experience sunny and warm weather with chances of isolated afternoon thunderstorms. A very broad low-pressure area south of Japan, meanwhile, may enter the Philippine area of responsibility from the northeast this weekend. It will not affect the country, but it is not seen to develop into a tropical cyclone and will remain in the middle of the Philippine Sea. It may slightly enhance the southwest monsoon early to midweek next week. Please continue monitoring for updates on this weather disturbance. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Happy weekend and back to you, Carmina.
And you have a good weekend too. A demolition job. That's how Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia described bribery and corruption allegations thrown against him by Sagip Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta. On Thursday, Marcoleta accused Garcia of having two offshore bank accounts. The lawmaker also filed a House resolution seeking to probe the COMELEC chief and South Korean coal automation provider Miru Systems. Garcia firmly denies the accusations. He is also daring his accusers to face him in court.
Handa at gusto kong magkaroon ng pagdinig sa ating Kongreso sapagkat sure na sure ako lalabas kung sino ang nasa likod po nito. Yung mga dokumento po habang aming pinag-aaralan, mga peke po eh, lalo na po yung banking system ng Amerika. Pinalabas po kasi doon na ako ay, kung hindi man citizen, ay permanenteng residente ng Amerika para makapagbukas ng isang account. Eh hindi pa po ako nakakapunta sa Amerika, nakakatuntong man lang, wala po akong visa. Ang lahat ng ito ay para sirain yung pong kredibilidad ng 2025 elections.
The Philippines' Tax Bureau banking on collections from online sellers in a bid to expedite its goal to reach the 3 trillion peso revenue collection target for this year. Andrea Taguines reports.
With only 5 months left in 2024, the Philippine Bureau of Internal Revenue admits attaining its goal of collecting 3 trillion pesos, or more than $51 billion in taxes, will be challenging. This year's revenue collection target is higher than the record-high tax collection of 2.5 trillion pesos in 2023. But speaking to reporters during the celebration of the BIR's 120th anniversary, Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. said the Bureau remains up for the challenge. Lumagi is particularly banking on collections from online sellers earning over 500,000 pesos a year after they were recently subjected to a 1% withholding tax.
Medyo challenging pa din, ano? Kaya naman patuloy pa rin ang ating pinahigting na mga activities para makuha ito. Especially itong withholding tax on online transactions. We're expecting that yung revenues natin dyan would be in the billions.
The tax chief said many online sellers continue to get away from paying taxes, but he vowed to keep running after them.
While tumataas ang tax efficiency ng BIR, bakit hindi rin ganun kataas ang nagiging collection? It's because sinasabi nga na ang daming nag-shift from traditional na mga purchases doon sa mga online. Yung iba, napakalalaki na talaga ng mga negosyo pero ayaw pa rin na magrehistro. Ang dami pa rin nating nakikita ang mga unregistered warehouses na kung saan nandyan nakatago ang mga produkto nitong mga malalaking negosyante na engaged dyan sa online na selling.
According to Lumagi, they also won't ease up in their campaign against tax evaders, fake receipts, and the smuggling of vape and other tobacco products. Another strategy to raise tax collections is the digitalization of BIR's processes.
Nag-launch din tayo ng bagong BIR web portal para mas user-friendly. At sa mga darating na taon, marami rin po tayong nilalatag na mga improvements ng agency sa digital transformation. Ang ginagawa natin, pinapadali natin ang pagko-comply ng mga taxpayers.
Meanwhile, the Bureau also unveiled a new logo on Thursday, a move that's consistent with the Marcos administration's Bagong Pilipinas rebranding initiative. The price tag, 150,000 pesos, which was awarded to 3 winners of a logo design contest the BIR held a few months back.
Wala naman tayong ibang naging gastos dyan, kundi yung pabuyang binigay natin dun sa tatlong nanalo ng ating pa-contest.
Lumagi also justified the logo change, saying the old one primarily showed limited and outdated industries. The new logo, he said, better reflects the BIR's vision and how it hopes to be perceived by the public. A Bureau of Integrity, Service, Excellence, and Patriotism. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.